This video shows how to use our computational model of Earth's climate. This model was developed to include many of the ideas from this unit that you identified in the last lesson, and we can use it to see how different factors affect Earth's systems and climate. In the boxes are different components, which indicate objects in the world or things that we can measure about our world. The components are connected by arrows, which represent interactions between the different components. A red arrow indicates that if the component at the start of the arrow changes, or let's say specifically increases, it will cause the factor or component at the end of the arrow to also increase. So if sea level increases, we would expect climate migration to increase. The blue arrows indicate that if the component at the start of the arrow increases, the component at the end of the arrow will actually do the opposite thing. It'll decrease. So if global atmospheric temperatures were to increase, we would expect polar land ice volume to decrease. Or the opposite. If atmospheric temperatures were to decrease, we would expect to see more polar ice. Now, the thickness of the arrows is also important because that indicates basically how much of an effect the object or component at the start of the interaction has on the one at the end. So this is a fairly thin arrow. So if solar activity increases a little bit, we only see a little bit of an increase in light reaching Earth's surface. Whereas if we see a small increase in sea level, we would expect to see a lot more climate migration. These are different ideas. There are assumptions baked into the model. Now each arrow is labeled with energy, matter, or both words to indicate whether the interaction involves a flow of energy, a flow of matter, or changes in energy and matter happening together and affecting each other. We can actually use this model by clicking Simulate, then changing any variable that has a slider. We can see the impact of this change by looking at the bar graphs attached to all the other components. In this way, we can run experiments in which one of these components with a slider is an independent variable, and all the other components that we can measure are dependent variables.